Welcome to another episode of Second Chance Vinyl, where I recollect my own record collection that has suffered years of dust, grit, and mold due to poor storage conditions, including flooding. In this video, I'll be refurbishing the album Dynasty by Kiss, or Dynasty for our North American friends. Dynasty was the seventh studio album and considered their comeback album after having a three-year gap after the release of Love Gun. I found the date of release of this copy on the inside sleeve cover, and according to the catalogue number, this album was part of the original 1979 release by Casablanca Records, distributed in Canada. Kiss released five singles from this album. Their biggest hit, I Was Made for Loving You, reached number two in the Aussie charts and ninth in the US. And Sure Know Something went to number five in Australia and only managed 47th in the US Billboard Hot 100. And some of you might have recognized that 2000 Man is a cover of an early Rolling Stones track. Now let's clean this record and put it back in the collection. Straight away, I'm worried about how many visible scratches I can see on this record. And also, there's clearly a lot of dust, grit, and even mold spots. My big concern is, once this record is clean, are these scratches going to make it unplayable? Unfortunately, side two doesn't look any better. This record really looks like it's been used as a frisbee in a car park. The clump of scratches that you can see on the left doesn't look great at all, and when I run my finger across it, it feels really rough. And that looks really nasty as well. Time to clean. First, I use a dry cloth to wipe down the label on both sides to get rid of any excess dirt and grit. I then clamp on the label protector to keep the label dry during the next stage of cleaning. I then make up a simple cleaning solution with dishwashing soap and water. And I'll use this baby's hairbrush during the first stage of washing. I rinse the record thoroughly to get rid of any excess dirt and grit, because you don't want that being caught in the bristles as you start scrubbing the record with the baby's hairbrush. Now, the bristles on the baby's hairbrush are so soft that you could even just wash against the grooves and it won't damage the record in any way. I always start at a point and I wash the record in four quarter sections. I usually spend a few minutes giving each side a good scrubbing, but for the sake of keeping this video from being too long, I've shortened this part with the edit. The record looks 40 years younger already. My second secret weapon is a super fine bristled toothbrush. These bristles give a deep clean within the grooves, and you know it does because you find you follow the grooves as you wash. Give the record an initial dry with a very soft microfiber cloth. I complete the drying process using a hairdryer. Now it's really important to remember to just keep this on a warm setting and keep the dryer moving at all times. The thing I like about using a dryer is that it does a really thorough job and you can play the record instantly once you're done. The before and after is spectacular. It looks incredible. However, this spot right here does have me concerned. It feels quite rough to run my finger across it. The record does look really clean. However, there are scratches everywhere. And the big question is, how is it going to sound? The record gets a new, clean, anti-static sleeve. The inside cover seems to have quite a few marks and stains, so I'll use a wet microfiber cloth to give it a wipe down and try and clean off any of these spots if I can. I then drive the sleeve immediately with a dry cloth to avoid any possible water damage. The inside of the cover is quite gritty, so I'll use a damp cloth again to try and remove as much of the contamination as possible. Might not seem like it, but I'm being incredibly gentle with this cover to try and avoid damaging the sleeve. Damp cloth again on the outside cover. A special mention to Robert Morgan, who left a comment in my last video to suggest making sure the open end of the inner record sleeve is facing the top of the outside cover to prevent dust from getting in. Now remember this bird's nest of scratches? Let's play that and see what it sounds like. That was Dynasty by Kiss, Dynasty for my North American friends. Arguably one of the biggest bands of the late 70s and early 80s and very much the glam of the glam rock era. Dynasty was the very last album recorded by all the original band members before Peter Criss, who was the drummer and the cat, was replaced by Eric Carr, who was the fox. And about 12 months later and about a record later, Ace Frehley left, claimed that there were some differences, Gene Simmons, of course, was saying that he was booted out of the band, but, you know, who knows what was what. Both Peter Criss and Ace Frehley would join the band again and leave the band again, but then they joined the band one last time for the end of the road tour, which only just finished at the end of last year, being 2022. Now, I was too young to be a member of the Kiss Army, who was their fan base, and they'd turn up to all the concerts. They'd be dressed up as their favourite Kiss member. They have the face paint on, you know, full body outfits, and of course they would rock on. But I did love Gene Simmons. That guy had me convinced he was a demon of some sort. He had this really demonic face paint on, yeah, really crazy frizzy long hair, and he had monster faces on the end of his boots. And the world's longest tongue. He had this really long tongue. I think it was an urban myth. People said that he cut the ligament just at the base of the tongue so he could push it out a bit further. He'd spit blood in the concerts. I mean, I love Paul Stanley as well. He had that simple star on his face, but you had to have a favorite. When someone said, who's your favorite, you know, member of Kiss? It was Gene Simmons. Now, I've got to say, I was really shocked by the way that this record turned out. When I first pulled the record out of the sleeve, it had everything I expected. There was a lot of dirt, there was grit, there's even mold. But the thing that had me most concerned, there was visible scratches all over the record on both sides, including that bird's nest of really rough scratches to touch, right in the middle of the track, Charisma. And I thought, you know what, if the rest of the record's okay, that's good enough for me. It's just the one song. But we played it. You heard what it sounded like. It was amazing. I couldn't hear any imperfections whatsoever. You know, even the cracks, if there were any, that were so light that you didn't notice them. And I think being part of a rock album, it hides the imperfections, which is brilliant. So really happy with the end result. So is Dynasty by Kiss going to be part of my new record collection? Is it going to be recollected? 100% it is. I'm so excited. Every single song sounds great. It's in the collection. I've got a record collection of two so far. So look, if you like this video, please click the like button, subscribe to it. That way you'll know when I've dropped a new video. Leave a comment. Love to hear what you think of the actual video itself, or if you've got a story about Kiss. And of course, if there's anyone you know that might like this video, please share it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.